Bob Hagar style. Oh. Let's have one more round of applause for our dancers, please. Let's go to Destination and Serena. And we'd like to give them a special thanks. And I'd like to thank you all for coming here today, our last performance of Darmok in the Park. Tomorrow night, or tomorrow afternoon, we'll be on tour to Corvallis.
Where no one has gone before. crossroads. And Lunga. Lunga, the sky is gray. Rye and Jiri. And Lunga.
Counselor?
I'm thinking of nothing but good intentions, Captain.
Data.
The Temerian seems to be stating the proper names of individuals and locations.
Yes, but what does it all mean?
I'm at a loss, sir.
Captain, I invite you to consider the creation of a mutual non-aggression pact between our two peoples, possibly leading to a trade agreement and cultural interchange. Does this sound like a reasonable approach?
Kadir, beneath Momote.
Remember to mark.
Impressions number one.
They seem to be trying their best.
As are we, for what it's worth.
Captain.
Darmok.
Ryan, Jiri, and Lunga.
Shaka.
Seaman and Anso. Seaman and Bakor.
Darmok and Tanara.
Shaka! Mirab, with sails unfurled.
Darmok.
Mirab, with
Tamar.
Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra.
Block the transporter beam with the shields. Extend to maximum range.
Not enough time.
Where is he?
Captain Picard has been transported to the surface with their captain.
Record O'Brien. Record O'Brien.
Transport will not be possible, sir. They have projected a particle scattering beam in the upper ionosphere.
Record to Captain Picard. Captain, could you read me? Can we compensate?
No, sir. The particle scattering beam is in the upper ionosphere. Virtually, the result is a hyper-ionization, which disrupts virtually all EM and subspace carriers.
So they can't communicate with their man either, or beam anybody through the field.
That is correct. However, they have left sensor frequencies open.
So they can read what's going on? Analysis, Mr. Worf, what the hell is going on?
A contest, perhaps, between champions. Our captain versus theirs.
Theirs was armed.
Darmok and Jalad.
You expect me to fight? Is that it? A challenge?
Darmok and Jalad.
I have no idea who or what Darmok and Jalad are, but I didn't come here to start a war.
Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra.
I refuse. Do you attack an unarmed man, Captain? There doesn't seem to be much challenge in that.
Tempo, it's arms wide.
I'm sorry, Captain.
I want him released.
Darmok at Tanagra.
Your actions could be interpreted as an act of war.
Hideo, his eyes closed. Kenza, of course. The Court of Silence. Kenza!
Is there any way to get through to them?
Not without further study.
Mr. Worf, close the channel.
Gladly, sir.
Security team, take a shuttle down to the planet. Go bring back the captain.
Aye, Commander.
Commander, the Temerians are quite capable of stopping a shuttle.
I'm aware of that, but blocking our transporter is one thing. Shooting on a shuttle, something else entirely. I'm betting they're not going to push it that far.
Shaka, when the walls fell.
Shaka indeed. What now, Captain? Will you attack me in my sleep?
I don't freeze to death first.
Darmok
the law of Kitue.
Picard of the Federation of the Starship Enterprise of the planet Earth.
Kadir, we need more Momote. Temba.
What do you mean? Fire? Temba means fire?
Temba is armed wide.
Temba is a person. His arms are wide because he's holding them apart. In generosity? In giving? In taking? Thank you.
Shuttlecraft down to the planet to find Captain Picard, gambling that the Temerians will back down rather than risk an exchange of phaser fire. I feel like I'm playing a deadly game. The captain's life is the prize, and I still don't understand the rules.
The positron density is 0.013. Electron concentration is 7.95. We are 250 kilometers from the planet's surface. The shuttle is approaching the planet's E region of the ionosphere.
How long can we maintain communications?
The particle scattering field is located in the upper D region. The shuttle will reach that area in approximately 2 minutes.
And the Temerian ship?
Unchanged, sir. They seem to be making no attempt to stop us.
Maybe we called their bluff. Wrecked Wharf, report.
Navigation, sensors, propulsion normal. The onboard systems do not appear to be affected by the field, but I can barely read you, Commander.
Understood, Lieutenant. Maintain communications as long as conditions
permit. Commander, I am reading a plasma surge in the Temerian ship's plasma reactor.
Mr. Worf, evasive maneuver sequence delta. Mr. Worf, evasive maneuver sequence delta.
The shuttle has been hit.
Damage.
The starboard nacelle has been rendered inoperable.
That's all. Wrecked Worf, report.
Starboard thrusters have been destroyed. I may be able to land, I will not be able to take off.
Understood, Lieutenant. Return to the Enterprise.
Aye, sir.
Enough to make them turn back, but not enough to hurt them?
Apparently so. The phaser pulse seems to be attenuated for just that effect.
Nice shooting.
Save the captain.
It will end this stalemate.
There's too much at risk. I'll take that course when it's the last one left. Who are these people? There's got to be some way to get through to them.
As I said before, with further study,
then do it. Deanna, help him. I want something by 0900 hours.
Where have you gone to, my friend? Forgive the intrusion, Captain, but I need some answers.
Darmok and Tanagra.
Shaka! Barab with sails unfurled.
Darmok, freeze.
Darmok, it seems to be a point of contention between them. Perhaps something the Tavarian captain proposed that his first officer didn't like?
The apparent emotional dynamic does seem to support that assumption. As with other terms used by the Tavarian, it appears to be a proper noun. The name clearly carries meaning.
Computer, search for the term Dharma in all linguistic databases compiled for this sector.
Searching. Dharma is the name of the seventh dynasty emperor on Kanda 4, a mythical historical hunter on Shantil 3, a colony on the Windy 7, a frozen dessert on Rosna 5.
Stop search. How many entries for Dharma?
47.
All our technology. Our universal translator, our computer from space. Contact with more alien cultures than I can even remember.
I have encountered 1,754 non-human races during my tenure at Starfleet.
And you still can't even say it's the globe.
That is correct.
I meant no harm.
Shaka, when the walls fell. Temba, it's on point.
Temba! Enough! I am...
It's Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra. Temba.
I'll take you up on that. Commander, sensors are picking up an electromagnetic disturbance approaching the captain's position.
Analysis!
It is a variable induction field, possibly a life form.
How close is it to the captain?
The field is erratic, appearing and disappearing, but it does seem to be moving towards him.
Attacking? Record of the Forge!
The Forge here!
Where are we at with those transporters?
About 2 hours, maybe three.
I want the captain out of there now.
That's not very likely, sir.
I don't want to hear that, Commander.
What's the resonance frequency?
0.34 over standard.
I want a resolution of 0.53 at the very least. Only 2 more minutes, Commander. But there is a good chance this isn't gonna work.
If it fails...
I know. We'll have tipped our hands at the Temerians, but that's a chance we've got to take.
Agreed. LaForge, proceed.
We're on it. LaForge out.
Riker to transporter room one.
O'Brien here, Commander.
Stand by, Mr. O'Brien. Come on.
Rob, with sails unfurled?
Come on.
Shaka, when the walls fell.
Shaka, you said that before, when I couldn't build a fire. Is it a failure? An inability to do something?
Darmok, Angelon,
and Tanagra. Yes, I remember the words, but I don't understand.
Matrix levels?
Annular conversion.
This isn't gonna do it. Increase thermal input coefficient to 100. 50%. Increasing now.
Abort status.
We're almost there, Commander. Shunt the overload to the phase transition sequencers in transporter one.
Yes, sir.
LaForge to O'Brien.
Go ahead, Commander.
Confirm phase sequencer linkage.
Link is confirmed. Ready when you are, sir.
Usani, his army at Lashmir.
At Lashmir? Is it like this at Lashmir? Similar to what we're facing now?
Usani, his army with fist open.
Strategy? Fist open. Fist open. Why? To lure the enemy?
His army with fist closed.
Fist closed. An army open to lure the enemy, then closed to attack. That's how you communicate, isn't it? By citing example, by metaphor. Usani, his army, with fist closed.
Sokat, his eyes uncovered.
No!
Got a piece of him, Commander, but that's all I've got.
LaForge, boost the confinement beam.
157 over standard.
It's as slow as it'll go, Commander.
The Temerian and the Entity are in close proximity to each other. The Temerian's life signs are fluctuating.
Scattering field is still in full force. What the hell is wrong with them? Their sensors can read what's going on as well as ours can. Riker to LaForge. Or Riker to O'Brien.
Field is still deflecting the signal, Commander. I just can't get enough of them.
Hail the Temerian ship.
Aye, Commander.
Your captain is under attack. Drop your particle field.
Kailash, when it rises.
They have closed the channel.
Trying to bridge. I couldn't hold him, Commander.
Shaka.
When the walls fell. First officer's log, stardate 45047.8. Our attempts to transport Captain Picard back to the ship has failed. My options are narrowing. My patience, all but gone. Here's the situation on El Adrel. The entity has moved off several hundred meters.
Captain Picard's bioscan readings were stable. The Temerians are not. He may have been injured.
If the entity attacks again, Captain could be facing it alone.
The transporter is completely out of the question. The Temerian ship has deepened the scattering field to the D region of the ionosphere. There's no getting through.
Unless we attack the ship directly.
Can you pinpoint the source of the particle beam?
They're using a polarity coil located aft of their warp drive. It's heavily shielded.
Can we get through with phasers?
Not with the first spread. It'll take a few hits.
That's not good enough. I want to be able to take out the scattering field one shot, have the captain back on the Enterprise before they knew what happened.
If we selectively target the amplification pathways located around the generator, it should be just as effective, and we can do it in one burst.
How long to set that up?
Worf and I will need to adjust the three fire chambers. That'll give us the focus we need. A few hours.
Make it so.
Aye, sir.
I would prefer to find a peaceful solution. If we can talk our way out of this, so much the better.
Unfortunately, it's not that simple.
Why, what have you found?
The Temerian ego structure does not allow for what we would normally identify as self-identity. Their ability to abstract is highly unusual. They seem to communicate through narrative imagery with people and locations taken from their mythical historical accounts.
It's as if I were to say to you,
an image of romance.
Exactly. Imagery is everything to the Temerians. It embodies their emotional states, their thought processes. It's how they communicate, and it's how they think.
Well, if we know how they think, can't we get something across to them?
No, sir. The situation is analogous to knowing the grammar, but none of the vocabulary of a language.
If I didn't know who Juliet was, or what she was doing on that balcony, the image alone would mean anything. That's correct. For instance, we know Darmok is a great hero, a hunter, a
narratives from which the Temerians are grabbing these images. Given our current relations, that does not seem possible.
Darmok and Jalad at Tanagra.
Our situation is similar to theirs, I understand. But I need to know more. Tell me more about Darmok. Tell me... Before, you used the words Temba, his arms wide, when you gave me the fire and the dagger. Could that mean give? Temba, his arms wide, Darmok. You mean more about Darmok.
Darmok, on the ocean.
Darmok, on the ocean. Darmok on the ocean, a metaphor for being alone, isolated. Darmok on the ocean. Are you alright?
Kiazi, his children, with faces wet.
Timba, his arms wide. Give me more. Darmok on the ocean.
Tanagra on the ocean. Darmok at Tanagra.
At Tanagra.
The country?
Tanagra on the ocean. An island. Timba, his arms wide.
Jalad on the ocean. Jalad at Tanagra.
Jalad at Tanagra. He went to the same island as Darmok, to Tanagra.
The beast at Tanagra.
The beast, a creature on the island. On Tanagra? Darmok and Jalad, did they fight the beast? They arrived separately. They struggled against the common foe. The beast at Tanagra. Darmok and Jalad.
Darmok and Jalad on the ocean.
They left together. Darmok and Jalad on the ocean.
Storyteller.
And besides, you wouldn't understand me anyway.
Shaka, when the walls fell.
But I guess that doesn't matter. You want to hear it anyway, don't you?
Alright.
There is a very ancient one from Earth. I'll try to remember. Gilgamesh. Tormented his subjects. He drove them to anger. They cried out, "Give our king a companion! Spare us from his madness!" A wild man from the forest entered the city. They fought in the temple. They fought in the streets. Gilgamesh defeated Enkidu. They became friends. Gilgamesh and Enkidu at Uruk. Friends went out into the desert, where the great bull of heaven was killing men by the hundreds. Enkidu seized it by the tail. Gilgamesh struck it with his sword. They were victorious.
Gilgamesh.
But Enkidu fell to the ground, struck down by the gods. And Gilgamesh. bitter tears, saying, "He who was my companion through adventure and hardships is gone forever."